Before we move on, so we mentioned that the sources of tafsir are five. The Quran, doing the tafsir of the Quran with the Quran, tafsir of the Quran with the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with the statements of the Salaf, with the Arabic language, and the reasons of revelation, which we discussed previously. In regards to the sayings of the Salaf, I wanted to touch upon that. Now, we don't have a separate slide for it, so make sure you write this down, inshallah. And here we want to discuss regarding who from the Salaf are the most, you know, the most famous, mostly mentioned when it comes to tafsir. Now, from the Sahaba, there were many. From the Sahaba, there were many. The four Khulafa. Yeah, obviously their statements, even though, you know, it wasn't that much, because obviously they were busy with being the Khalifa. So they were busy with the affairs of the Muslims and so on. And that's also an answer why, you know, somebody asks you, why is it Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, if you only accepted Islam in the 7th year of after Hijrah, i.e. just over 3 years, and Abu Bakr accepted Islam in the beginning, from the beginning, how is it that Abu Hurairah has narrated more hadith than Abu Bakr? One of the answers is this, that after the death of the Prophet ﷺ, they were busy, the Khulafa were busy with governing the Muslims. Whereas Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, he had nothing, you know, else to do in terms of a job, so he was just free to narrate. So that's one of the answers you can give to that. And also, you know, Abu Bakr passed away quite quickly compared to Abu Hurairah. Abu Hurairah passed away, I think, 59 after Hijrah. Whereas Abu Bakr, just 2 years after the Prophet, and then 10 years later, Umar, and then 12 years later, Uthman, and then 5 years after that, Ali radiallahu anhu. Also from the most famous, Ibn Abbas, Ibn Mas'ud, Abdullah ibn al-Zubayr, Ubayy ibn Ka'b, Ubayy ibn Ka'b, Zayd ibn Thabit, Zayd ibn Thabit, Abu Musa al-Ash'ari, Abu Musa al-Ash'ari, and others. And then after the Sahaba came many of the Tabi'een, and they studied from these companions. And you know, there are many to be mentioned, but the best way I think we can explain it is to mention that in the time of the Tabi'een, what happened was there were three main madaris, three main schools of tafsir. Okay? And each of these three, their main teacher was a companion. So these three were firstly in Mecca. We had a madrasa in Mecca, which is the madrasa of Abdullah ibn Abbas. Abdullah ibn Abbas. And I'll mention the three madaris first, then I'll mention the students. And then in Medina, we had Ubay ibn Ka'b. In Medina, we had Ubay ibn Ka'b radiallahu anhu. And then in Iraq, we had Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. We had Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu. So these are the three main madaris of tafsir. In Mecca, you had Ibn Abbas. In Medina, Ubayy ibn Ka'b. And in Iraq, Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu. Ibn Abbas, Ubayy ibn Ka'b, and Ibn Mas'ud. These three. And each of these three had a number of students from the Tabi'een who are, if you were to read the books of tafsir, even maybe Ibn Kathir, you'll hear these names quite frequently. So we'll start off with the madrasa of Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu. Now Ibn Abbas in Mecca, we're going to mention four of his main students. The first is Mujahid. His full name Mujahid ibn Jabr. Mujahid ibn Jabr. The second is Sa'id. Sa'id ibn Jubair. Sa'id ibn Jubair. The third is Ata'. Ata' ibn Abi Rabah. Ata' ibn Abi Rabah. And the fourth is Ikrimah. 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 Ikrimah Mawla ibn Abbas. Ikrimah Mawla ibn Abbas. The freed slave of Ibn Abbas. So these were the four main students of Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, Mujahid, Sa'id, Atah, and Ikrimah rahimahumullah jami'ah. As for Medina, Ubay ibn Ka'b, his main students, we'll mention three of them. The first is Zayd ibn Aslam. Zayd ibn Aslam. The second is Abu al-Aliyah. Abu al-Aliyah. And the third is Muhammad ibn Ka'b. Muhammad ibn Ka'b. And as for the madrasa of Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, then he had a number of students from them. Masruq. Masruq. Qatada. Second is Qatada. Al-Hasan al-Basri. Al-Hasan al-Basri. الضحاك الضحاك no, I'm going to suffice with these four inshallah. So I'll quickly repeat all the names inshallah. So in Mecca we had the madrasa of Ibn Abbas, and in Medina Ubay ibn Ka'b, and in Iraq Ibn Mas'ud. As for the students of Ibn Abbas in Mecca, they were Mujahid ibn Jabr, Sa'id ibn Jubair, Ata ibn Abi Rabah, and Ikrimah Mawla ibn Abbas. In Medina, the students of Ubay ibn Ka'b were Zayd ibn Aslam, Abu al-Aliyah, and Muhammad ibn Ka'b. And as for the students of Ibn Mas'ud in Iraq, were Masruq, Qatada, Al-Hassan al-Basri, and Al-Dahak. And maybe if you want to write in an easy way, you can just, the way I've done it is you just draw a tree diagram. Right? Ibn Abbas in Mecca, Ubay ibn Ka'b in Medina, and Ibn Mas'ud in Iraq, and underneath each name you write the students, so it's like summarized in a nice easy way, like that. Inshallah, maybe I'll add it as a separate slide later on inshallah. So I think this is really important, that if somebody wants to do tafsir, these are names that you have to be familiar with. Not only do you have to be familiar with the names of the books, Ibn Kathir, Tabari, Qurtubi, and so on, which inshallah today we'll talk about, but also the narrators of tafsir. Remember, from the source of tafsir for Ibn Kathir and Qurtubi, what? We mentioned five. From them, the sayings of the Salaf. Who are the Salaf that are going to be mentioned? The main ones are the ones that we just mentioned right now. So even if you were to open up Ibn Kathir, you'll find these names. So now at least you know who these, you know, generally, who these people are, which madrasa are they from, and who their teachers are.